The Trimble Access Limit box allows you to spatially isolate data to help with managing complex and large data sets. Turn on the Limit box from the Map toolbar. The bounds of the Limit box are now visible and the box is created around the current map view. Moving the Limit box to a new location is straightforward. You can use the sliders to fine-tune and resize the box. You can switch between the top and bottom of the box, the left and right of the box, and the front and back. You can even tap and hold on the elevation sliders to key in a value. To move the box to another location, tap and hold the Fit to View button to set the limit box extents to that of the job, and then adjust the map view and tap the Fit to View button. The limit box will shift to the new map position. The limit box also aligns to the map's rotation, letting you easily position it around any object. Once you've set the limit box to the desired position, tap the highlighted slider button to hide the slider and the box. Now you can work undistracted by the things in the map. Once you've finished your task and you close the limit box, its dimensions will be stored. Next time you open the limit box in that job, it will appear in the same location as last time. This lets you disable the limit box to do essential tasks, like checking backsites on control, and then reactivate the limit box to focus back on the previous task. Set a favorite key to toggle the limit box to easily turn it on and off in the map. The limit box can be extremely useful when focusing on data within a point cloud, like this example here. Turning to engineering surveying, the limit box can also be useful when scrutinizing intricate model components and trying to get inside of a model. In this building model, the limit box allows me to focus on columns and beams, which helps with analysis and validation of the as-built surface against the model.